चलो भाई देखो, चैप्टर फर्स्ट से वापस से रिवीजन करते हैं। चैप्टर फर्स्ट रिवीजन क्लास, चैप्टर फर्स्ट रिवीजन क्लास। देखिए भाई, फर्स्ट चैप्टर हमारा है केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड इक्वेशंस, केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड केमिकल इक्वेशंस। केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड केमिकल इक्वेशंस, सबसे पहले बात है ध्यान दें, कोई भी केमिकल रिएक्शन है, सपोज हमारे पास एक रिएक्शन है ए प्लस बी और ये रिएक्शन करने पर बनाती है सी, तो आपको ध्यान रखना है इन अ केमिकल रिएक्शन, इन अ केमिकल सब्सटेंस या रिएक्शन In a chemical reaction, substances which are involved, जो भी substances involved होते हैं, the substances which are taking place in a chemical reaction, in a chemical reaction, the substances which are taking in a chemical reaction, the substances which are taking, the which are involving, कुछ भी लिख सकते हो आप, ठीक है, तो the substances which are taking participation, which are taking participation या which are taking part, which are taking part in a chemical reaction, the substances which are taking part are known as रिएक्टेंट्स, क्या बोलते हैं उनको हम, रिएक्टेंट्स बोलते हैं। दो सब्सटेंसेस विच आर टेकिंग पार्ट इन अ केमिकल रिएक्शन, ऐसे सब्सटेंसेस जो रिएक्शन में पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं दे आर नोन एज रिएक्टेंट्स, उनको हम रिएक्टेंट्स बोलते हैं। तो यहां पर ए एंड बी, तो ए एंड बी आर रिएक्टेंट्स, तो ए और बी क्या हो गए यहां पर, रिएक्टेंट्स हो गए। इसी तरह आपको ध्यान रखना है द न्यू सब्सटेंसेस, द न्यू सब्सटेंसेस विच आर फॉर्म्ड, which are formed during a reaction, during a chemical reaction, the new substances which are formed during a chemical reaction are known as products, आर नोन एज प्रोडक्ट्स। तो वो सब्सटेंसेस जो रिएक्शन में नए सब्सटेंसेस जो बनते हैं उनको क्या बोलते हैं हम, उनको हम बोलते हैं प्रोडक्ट्स। तो इस रिएक्शन में आपको ध्यान रखना है जो सी है, सी जो है वो क्या है आपका, प्रोडक्ट, ठीक है, तो ध्यान रखना है यहां पर सी जो है, सी इज प्रोडक्ट। जैसे सपोज करो आपने जिंक की रिएक्शन कराई कॉपर सल्फेट के साथ, फॉर एग्जाम्पल जिंक की रिएक्शन कराई कॉपर सल्फेट के साथ, इट विल फॉर्म जिंक सल्फेट प्लस कॉपर, तो यहां पर आपको ध्यान रखना है रिएक्टेंट्स और प्रोडक्ट्स। रिएक्टेंट्स है आपके जिंक एंड कॉपर सल्फेट, प्रोडक्ट है आपके जिंक सल्फेट एंड कॉपर। तो आपको ध्यान रखना है दीज आर जिंक एंड कॉपर सल्फेट आर रिएक्टेंट्स इन दिस रिएक्शन एंड जिंक सल्फेट एंड कॉपर आर प्रोडक्ट्स। ठीक है, आगे बात करें अगर नेक्स्ट उसके बाद में अगर बात करें सिमिलरली ये कह रहा है जब मैग्नीशियम की रिएक्शन कराते हैं बर्निंग ऑफ मैग्नीशियम रिबन। बर्निंग ऑफ मैग्नीशियम रिबन, जब हम मैग्नीशियम की रिएक्शन कराते हैं ऑक्सीजन से वी विल गेट मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड। क्या मिलता है हमें? मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड। मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड वी विल गेट मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड। सो दिस इज मैग्नीशियम रिबन, मैग्नीशियम रिबन। इंपॉर्टेंट नोट, बिफोर बर्निंग मैग्नीशियम रिबन it should be cleaned with sandpaper. This is done, it is done to remove, it is done to remove basic, it is done to remove basic magnesium oxide and मैग्नीशियम कार्बोनेट लेयर, मैग्नीशियम कार्बोनेट लेयर। सो बिफोर बर्निंग मैग्नीशियम रिबन इट शुड बी क्लीन विद सैंड पेपर। इट इज डन टू रिमूव बेसिक मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड एंड मैग्नीशियम कार्बोनेट लेयर फ्रॉम मैग्नीशियम from magnesium ribbon. From magnesium ribbon. Next types of chemical reactions. Types of chemical reactions. Types of chemical reactions. So first one is, there are two types of chemical reactions. There are two types of chemical reactions. Number one is balanced chemical reaction. Balanced chemical reactions and number second is unbalanced chemical reactions. So first one is balanced chemical reactions. Balanced chemical reactions. Those reactions in which number of atoms of reactants in which number of atoms of reactants those reactions in which number of atoms of reactants and products and number of atoms of reactants and products are same or equal. Those reactions in which number of atoms of reactants and products are same. For example, calcium carbonate decomposes into calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. So there are one atom of calcium, one atom of carbon and three atom of oxygen. Similarly here calcium, number of atoms of calcium 1, carbon 1 and oxygen 3. So this is the example of balanced chemical equation. Second example, NH3 plus HCl, arrow NH4Cl. Here also number of atoms of nitrogen is 1, hydrogen 4 and chlorine 1. Here also number of atoms of nitrogen 1, hydrogen 4 and Cl 1. So number of atoms of reactants and products are same. That's why this is also a balanced chemical equation. Now second one is unbalanced chemical reaction. unbalanced chemical reaction. Unbalanced chemical reaction. Those reactions In which number of atoms of reactants, those reactions in which number of atoms of reactants are not are not equals to that of product. Those reactions in which number of atoms of reactant are not equals to that of products. For example, N2 plus 3H2 gives NH3. Here, there are two atoms of nitrogen and two atoms of hydrogen. Here, there are one atom of nitrogen and three atoms of hydrogen. So this is an unbalanced chemical reaction. Another example, H2 plus Cl2, arrow HCl. Here also, number of hydrogen atom is 2, number of Cl atom is also 2, whereas number of hydrogen is 1. And number of chlorine atom is also 1. So, this is not a balanced equation. So, what we have to do? So, we have to balance this reaction. So, we have to balance chemical equation. We have to balance chemical reaction to satisfy law of conservation of mass. So we have to balance a chemical reaction to satisfy law of conservation of mass. So for example, H2 plus Cl2, this gives HCl. So here there are two hydrogen atoms, there are two chlorine atoms. So we have to multiply this. So what we have to do? We have to multiply HCl with 2. So H2 plus Cl2, 2HCl. Now this is the balance equation. So we have to balance the chemical equation to satisfy law of conservation of mass. Similarly, another example is nitrogen when reacts with hydrogen, it gives ammonia. So what we have to do? We know that here there are nitrogen atoms 2, hydrogen atoms also 2. Nitrogen atoms 1 and hydrogen atoms 3. So first of all, we have to balance nitrogen. So we multiply NH3 with 2. So N2 plus H2, 2NH3. Now there are 2 atoms of nitrogen, 2 atoms of hydrogen. There are 2 nitrogen atoms, but hydrogen atoms are 6. So what we do? We multiply hydrogen molecule with 3. So now N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. Here there are 2 nitrogen atoms, 6 hydrogen atoms. 2 nitrogen atoms, 6 hydrogen atoms. Now this is the balanced chemical equation. This is the balanced chemical equation. Okay? Next, important note, in a chemical reaction, old bonds breaks and new bonds are formed. There is rearrangement of atoms. There is rearrangement of atoms in a chemical reaction. So during a chemical reaction, there is rearrangement of atoms in a chemical reaction to satisfy the law of conservation of atom. Okay, atoms can neither be created nor be destroyed, but they can be reshuffled. Unko aap reshuffle kar sakte ho, rearrangement kar sakte ho. For example, suppose AB when reacts with CD, it will form AC and BD, or it will form AD and BC. So in this reaction, when AB reacts with CD, it will form AC plus BD or AD plus BC. Okay, so there is a rearrangement in atoms. Old bonds breaks and new bonds are formed. Now, types of reactions. Our next topic is types of reaction. Types of reactions. We will continue this topic from tomorrow. Okay? Types of reactions. First one is combination reaction. These are the names of reactions. Second is dissociation or decomposition. Third one is displacement. Fourth one is double displacement. Fifth one is oxidation reduction. Oxidation reduction reactions. So we have to study these reactions. Now we will continue from tomorrow this topic. Thank you.